thought this week I'd share with you my personal opinions on Beatles Slash, which some of you may also know as Beatles fanfiction. I know what you're thinking. Eleanor, why do you always start so many controversies? Well, there's a simple answer to that. I'm a loud mouth. And since I'm so opinionated, I thought that the best way to get out my opinion would be, about the Beatly world, would be through, Tumblr and the Beatles Crafts. And I'm not trying to give the Beatles Crafts a bad name, trust me, I'm not. But, you know, I think it's a good opportunity to say what I have to say, and then you guys can think of your own opinion about whatever that I had to say. Don't get me wrong, there's, like, nothing wrong with liking Beatles fanfiction. It's just that you have to learn to take some things in moderation. And Beatles Slash, it gets so intense at times that it gets to the point where it's almost offensive. And really, it's mostly all about John and Paul having sex and doing things. If you've read some of the stories, which I'm pretty sure a lot of you have, you know what I'm talking about, but it gets offensive. And, of course there was some kind of chemistry going on with John and Paul, but I don't think it was that severe, and that intense. I don't think if they, like, if Paul or Ringo, or even if John were still around today, if they ever, like, stumbled upon the fanfiction, they'd say, oh, let's go have a hot orgy right now. I think they'd probably be kind of creeped out, in my opinion. I don't think they'd want to really read it or anything. Like I said, nothing's wrong with liking Beatles Slash. But, you know, it's just, it's one of those things you don't want to throw yourself into or throw it into other people's faces or blow it out of proportion and make relationships something they're not. Because, I myself used to be a reader of Beatles fanfiction. And, you know, I used to enjoy it, and then people just started being obsessed with it, and I got sick of it, I got tired of it, and I got angry with it. This is just my opinion, but I don't really think, these things would have happened in real life, which, realistically, they probably wouldn't, because if you've read some of the stories, you know what I mean. And I mean, sometimes Slash is funny. Like, it can be funny. Just don't come on too strong with it, if you know what I mean. Like, you want to keep it healthy. Because, you know, fanfiction is always good. And, these feelings at ages like mine, and maybe some of the other readers, are perfectly normal. And there's no real problem with it, but if you want to make it intense, like I see on some sites, then it's a little bit unhealthy, and it gets kind of disrespectful and rude, even. I'm trying to see both sides of the story for readers and non-readers, and people who are just tired of seeing it, but that's how I feel about Slash, and, you know, you have your opinion, and I have my opinion, so let's leave it at that. In other news, I talked about this last year, but last year, it'll be, it's the fourth. Okay, so this story that I was about to tell you will be for next week. So the fourth. I want to say Happy Independence Day to my friends in the USA. Obviously, I am not from the US, but Happy Independence Day. And have a great one with lots of fireworks, because fireworks are always good. Have lots of fireworks, have lots of barbecues. To be honest, I had a very boring Canada Day, so I hope you guys have a better Independence Day or 4th of July, whatever you might call it, and better than my Canada Day. Congratulations, and I'll see you guys next week with a story, which won't take up the whole video because I already talked about it last year. So, I'll see you guys next week, and Fishy's going to the Philippines, so have a good trip, Fishy, and I just learned that Carly's on a cruise, so have a good time, Carly. for however much longer you're staying there. But have a good time, and I'll see you guys all next week. So yeah.